2023 launch schedule, Amazon's broadband satellites, Elon Musk's Starship, and more. Have you heard about it? Not only does Amazon deliver your modem to your house, but it also delivers its broadband connection to space. And did you know 2023 will see the first ever commercial launch from the UK by Virgin Orbit? We invite you to explore this magical opportunity and join us in witnessing history being made. Be part of the pioneering step towards making spaceflight accessible and enjoyable. Watch this amazing video to learn more about the upcoming rocket launches in 2023. You won't want to miss it. January. Transporter 6. Where? Cape Canaveral, Florida. 2023 began with such a bang. For the fifth time, Elon Musk's SpaceX successfully launched the Falcon 9 rocket from Cape Canaveral on January 3rd. This launch is really important because the rocket put Transporter 6 into orbit. The Transporter 6 mission will launch an agriculture-focused satellite for the company EOSDA, a company that provides fast and actionable data to drive business and at the same time preserve our planet. Transporter 6 will put EOS SAT-1 into orbit, which will be the last of the 144 satellites to deploy the Transporter 6 mission. RS-1. Where? Pacific Spaceport Complex, Alaska. ABL Space Systems is a California-based startup. It tried to launch its RS-1 rocket multiple times from the Pacific Spaceport Complex, Alaska, in the very last months with no success. Every time, another technical issue. The story of my life. But the team doesn't despair, and they will try again on January 9, 2023. The rocket will try to deliver to orbit two CubeSats to test marine data communications operations. Good luck again, RS-1. By the end of January, GSAT-7C, where? Sriharikota, India, and Virgin Orbit, where? Spaceport, Cornwall, UK. By the end of January, we will probably have other fantastic launches. First of all, the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, is expected to launch GSAT-7C. India was the seventh country to be capable of undertaking orbital launches, and we are sure that the launch is another piece of the GSAT-7 mission, which will be more than successful. GSAT-7 is an advanced communication satellite built by ISRO to provide communication capabilities to users over a wide oceanic region, including the Indian landmass. Virgin Orbit is also supposed to launch by the end of the month. People in the UK are impatiently waiting for this moment to come because this will be the first space launch from Cornwall. Everyone is excited, except for the fact that, as usually happens with rockets, the launch from Cornwall is facing delays. There will be a Boeing 747 nicknamed Cosmic Girl that will carry a rocket under its left wing to an altitude of about 35,000 feet or 10 kilometers, where it drops the liquid-fueled booster into a free fall. Roughly 4 seconds into that fall, the rocket known as Launcher 1 will ignite its first stage engine and begin its climb to orbit. The overall mission, called Start Me Up, will be a launch of many firsts. The first orbital launch ever from the United Kingdom, the first international launch for Virgin Orbit, and the first commercial launch from Western Europe. February. Progress 83P, where? Baikonur Spaceport, Kazakhstan. The departure of the Russian cargo shuttle called Progress 83P towards the ISS will probably take place on February 16, 2023. But in addition to this, February should be the orbital launch of Starship from the Boca Chica base. Starship test flight, where? Boca Chica base, United States. Starship will be put into orbit thanks to a super heavy vector of SpaceX. This is a test program. However, any dates and times are simply an estimate based on publicly known information. This will be an important test because a modified version of the vehicle called Moonship is expected to act as a lander in the Artemis 3 mission, the one destined in 2025 or 2026 to bring the first woman and the next man to the moon. Crew 6 mission, where? Cape Canaveral, Florida. The takeoff of Crew 6 mission will probably take place in February as well, as 4 astronauts are going for a long stay on the ISS. Kuiper Sat 1 and 2, where? Cape Canaveral, Florida. Amazon, the big company led by Jeff Bezos, created Project Kuiper because it wants to deliver fast and affordable broadband to unserved and underserved communities around the world. Kuiper SAT 1 and 2 are only the first two of the whole satellite constellation of Amazon. Overall, the United Launch Alliance's ULA, New Vulcan Centaur rocket, is scheduled to provide 47 launches. March. Close to the Dubai Space Ops 23, the 17th edition of the International Conference on Space Operations, Polaris Dawn, the first space mission of the commercial Polaris program, will also start. Polaris Dawn, where? Kennedy Space Center, Florida. The launch, to be the first of its kind for a commercial crew mission, will utilize the SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft to transport its payload. The mission is expected to bring dramatic advances focusing on breakthroughs in space exploration, technology, and communications. It will be equipped with cutting-edge equipment and technology, as well as advanced communication capabilities. It will also offer new insights into Earth's climate, as well as facilitate research into observational astronomy. The mission will be powered by renewable energy, aiming to reduce reliance on conventional fuel sources. The 16 members aboard the mission are highly experienced, and the mission is expected to be highly successful. The Polaris program launch will be a major milestone in space exploration, and many are looking forward to the results of the mission. But this is not the end of it. The ISRO will try to launch the first orbital vehicle for human transports. Its name is Gaganyaan. Gaganyaan, where? Sri Harikota, India. About 16 minutes after liftoff from the Satish Dhawan Space Center, SDSC Sri Harikota, the rocket will inject the spacecraft into an orbit 300 to 400 kilometers, or 190 to 250 miles above the Earth. When ready to land, its service module and solar panels will be disposed of before re-entry. The capsule would return for a parachute splashdown in the Bay of Bengal. April. April will be a juicy month. Finally, the European Space Agency, ESA, will have the chance to launch one of its most awaited and important scientific missions, the Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, also known as JUICE. JUICE will start with the launch of an Ariane 5 from the Kourou Base in French Guiana. JUICE mission, where? Kourou Base, French Guiana. This amazing mission will be headed to Jupiter and its moons arriving in July of 2031. It will be an important step towards the understanding of the icy moons such as Ganymede, Europa, and Callisto, and it will probably give us unique insights in the possibility of life as we know it. Who knows, maybe some small organisms hide under the icy crust of such incredible worlds. In fact, scientists are pretty sure an ocean of liquid water hides under the ice. In April, the first manned flight of Boeing's CST-100 Starliner spacecraft is expected to launch. Starliner, where? Cape Canaveral, Florida. This mission will bring veterans of the shuttle missions Barry Butch Wilmore and Sunita Williams into orbit. Moreover, Starliner will be one of the means of transport to and from the International Space Station. I'm so excited. What about you? May. Do you know what a taikonaut is? It's a Chinese astronaut. Shenzhou spacecraft to Tiangong, where? Jiquan Satellite Launch Center, Gobi Desert. The launch date has not been made public, but a trio of taikonauts will be sent to Tiangong in May. Tiangong is not a city, guys. It is the Chinese modular space station. A Shenzhou spacecraft will do the job. There will probably be space for Sentinel-1C, a satellite of the Copernicus constellation to be launched. Sentinel-1C, where? Kourou, French Guiana. Copernicus is the most ambitious Earth observation program to date. It provides accurate, timely, and easily accessible information to improve the management of the environment, understand and mitigate the effects of climate change, and ensure civil security. June. Chandrayaan 3. Where? Sriharikota, India. India will be in the game again in June. The Chandrayaan 3 mission should take off by the end of the month. Indians are now determined to bring a rover and a lander to the lunar surface, having missed the opportunity in 2019 when the spacecraft crashed in September. Go ISRO. July, Luna 25, where Vostochny Cosmodome, Russia. In July, we will have the opportunity to dream about the moon again. The Luna 25 mission of Roscosmos, the Russian space agency, is expected to bring a lander close to the lunar south pole. In its current form, Luna 25 is a lander with the primary mission of providing the landing technology, but the mission will also carry scientific instruments, including a robotic arm for soil samples and drilling hardware. And while Russia will be going to the moon, ESA will explore the so-called dark universe. Euclid, where? Cape Canaveral, Florida. In July, the launch window for the Euclid satellite will finally open. The satellite will map the universe and will observe billions of galaxies distant up to 10 billion light years from Earth. August. The hot summer won't be able to stop space activities in New Zealand. In August, the Kinney 11 to 15 mission is expected to take off. Kinney mission, where? New Zealand. It will bring the third batch of five satellites for the French Kinney IoT constellation. This constellation of satellites allows any object equipped with a compatible transceiver to be located across the world and to transmit data collected from its measurement sensors. It also provides a special type of connectivity called IoT, which is available everywhere, especially in remote areas where no other network is available. Crew 7, where? Cape Canaveral, Florida. Then the grand finale. The Crew 7 mission to the International Space Station will also take place. Operated by SpaceX, the expedition will see the return to orbit of Andreas Mogensen, Danish ESA astronaut. September. Psych. Where? Florida. In September, Falcon Heavy will once again be on the ramp to take off with an interplanetary mission called Psych. Psych will provide us with precious insights from the main belt asteroid 16 Psych, which will be reached in 4 years. Scientists speculate 16 Psych is a remnant of the core of an early planet. Studying these kinds of objects will offer us clues to how the solar system formed and later evolved. October. No missions are apparently scheduled for October, but from the 2nd to 6th in Azerbaijan, the 74th edition of the International Astronautical Congress will take place. Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan, will host the IAC again 50 years after it did so for the first time in 1974. November and December. Ariane 6, where? Europe's spaceport, French Guiana. The end of 2023 will be spectacular and crucial, especially for European space. Finally, the new launcher, Ariane 6, will take off. Ariane 6 already has 18 launches planned with Amazon's Kuiper satellites, but it could also house Susie, a European vehicle that could transport humans into space. This period will be a turning point for the world's improvement. Thanks to data collected on Earth, for example, better methods of managing resources will be developed and shared between countries. In addition, space will no longer be the domain of large countries and organizations, but will become more accessible to the private sector, providing new opportunities for innovation. 2023 will be a great year for space exploration and the world's future. Many incredible new projects and ideas will be brought to life, and we will be able to see the results of our current and future efforts to promote a better and more sustainable world. Did you like this video? Why don't you subscribe and press the like button? See you soon on the channel.